Hello and welcome back to another news video with me, Meoni, and we have the wonderful news that Valentiones Day is coming back and we've got some confirmed dates and times for this event, which is very exciting. Before we scroll down, you'll see that there's actually this beautiful split image here, sort of comic book style, with a yellow character, a red character and a blue character. Sort of reminds me a little bit like Ruby villains or something. I don't know why, probably the hats and the color. But we also have this beautiful Aura that's been drawn at the front here, wearing one of the new outfits that's from this event. And indeed, yes, we're getting a new glamour set. But before we get to the nitty gritty, let's see. This will actually be taking place from Wednesday, January the 29th, 2020 at 12 a.m. PST until Sunday, February the 9th. So let's talk about how this works. So there's actually a special mechanic around this with a voting period. So the voting starts, this will make sense in a minute, I promise. The voting starts from Wednesday, January the 29th, 2020 at 12 a.m. PST and ends on Sunday, February the 9th, 2020 at 6:59 a.m. PST, where basically during that time you'll have a choice of characters during a storyline that you get to choose from. And it is server-wide progression, so you can actually vote for the, you know, the best character or the best option in that questline. They're not giving too much away in terms of a spoiler for that, but essentially we're going to have server-wide progression of choosing which character we ultimately get the reward from. Now, this is obviously quite different. The results from this sort of like in-game poll will be announced on Sunday, February the 9th, 2020 at 7 a.m. PST. And obviously those results will be available until Monday, February the 17th. And indeed when the event ends at 6:59 a.m. PST as well. So to kick this all off, you need to go to Old Gridania on the date when voting begins, and indeed the event begins on January 29th. And the quest is called Of Ardor and Argument. Lisette has returned to share the ardor and affection of House Valentiones with lovelorn Eorzeans the realm over. This has the obvious requirements of being level 15 and completing the It's Probably Pirates questline. So if you're a new player to the game, you just have to complete some of the main storyline and be level 15 and go to Gridania and you should be able to take part in this questline. Now during this voting period, as it says, Lisette's three protégés are competing to see which of them most deserves to assume the role of Emissary of Love for this year's festival. To that end, a vote will be held to decide who among them can offer the most inspired and insightful advice to Eorzea's lovelorn. You may only vote once during the course of this quest. Your vote will be counted in the world where it was completed. So we have Astrid there, so the red heart. We have Rodigalt for a blue heart, and we have Bert for yellow heart. I'm not really sure why anybody would choose Bert, but there we go. I'm more of an Astrid person myself, but essentially what will happen is, as they say, choose your emissary and show your colors with one of three endearing sets of festive garb. Now there is a male attire and a female attire, so these are gender locked. However, they are essentially all three the same outfit and they're fully dyeable. And the reason they say they've done this is so that, say for instance, the poll results come in and the red one wins, but you really wanted the blue one to win, you could just dye it blue and you know, it would be the same color as the blue one, which you wouldn't ordinarily win. So essentially they are all the same outfit and your choices don't really matter because we have a dyeability. This does give us a great opportunity to see what these outfits look like dyed, considering the red or blue or yellow part in those images shows us pretty much exactly what part will be dyeable. It reminds me a little bit like Alice in Wonderland or something with the, you know, the heart army or something like that, the cards. But yeah, it's quite interesting. I would say that the female outfit does look kind of 10 times better than the male, but some people might enjoy that. I just think that the males look a little bit like a jockey or something in horse racing, and the females just looks like crazy heart dress, which I always quite like. I like that frill actually as well. But before we get sidetracked talking about glamour, there is actually more to read, and they say that the votes will be counted separately for each world. Furthermore, the event will change as players continue to cast their votes, the results of which will determine what additional quests can be accepted as they progress through the story. It is possible to accept a progress through subsequent quests on a world other than your home world. Please note, however, the results of voting will influence which quests can be obtained on your data center. As a result, rewards for quests that have been made unavailable cannot be obtained. So I mean, it kind of can be if you think about it, considering you can actually just dye the outfit. But this is a pretty interesting sort of dip of the toe into new technology, and quite a different sort of event, you'll have to agree. Additionally to this, without anything remotely to do with that voting, you'll be able to also get another event item, the chocolate fountain. This is a fondue set, as you can see. So it appears to be like there's two different types of chocolate fountain. I don't know. It does say they're dyeable, so whether or not this means that the tablecloth and the fountain's dyeable, as you can see, there's a few differences between left and right there, or if they're just two separate items, because if you can see on the one on the left, it's mostly fruit and sort of pineapples and stuff in a basket, and the one on the right is just strawberries and sort of, I don't know, straws or something with like a normal fondue set. I'm not really sure, but it's going to be an interesting decorative item. But yeah, that's another housing item. So what do you think about this event? What do you think about the idea of trying out this new technology? It's definitely different. I've not seen them do something like this before. It's quite exciting. Yeah, and this could lead into other stuff. We've already talked before in the past about how technology that they try out in little events here and there is pretty much testing, beta testing live for future things that they actually could use this for. And server-wide progression is not something new. This is probably stemmed from the Ishgard restoration stuff as well. So we'll have to wait and see what this turns into. But until then, we get a nice comfy looking outfit for sure. Let me know what you think about the outfit below and which team you're on. Personally, I'm on Team Astrid. Go Astrid! Red Hearts forever. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all next time.